So let me end with a story. In March 1992, the embassy of Israel in Buenos Aires was blown up by Arab terrorists. Many were killed. And among the missing was a young mother called Yael Michaeli. Amid the carnage and the havoc and the confusion of the wreckage, our own Mossad people could not find her. So her sister and brother-in-law in New York desperately phoned Rabbi Moshe Kotlarsky to see if he could find Lubavitchers in Buenos Aires to find Yael Michaeli. By this time, it was after midnight, and Rabbi Kotlarsky urgently contacted a number of Lubavitchers in Buenos Aires, among them a Rabbi Tzvi Grumblat. And Rabbi Grumblat did find Yael Michaeli in hospital. She was alive, but severely burnt. He immediately called back Rabbi Kotlarsky to pass on the news to her family. And Rabbi Grumblat did not leave Yael Michaeli's bedside for a moment. He sat with her throughout the night, feeding her soul, her neshama, by saying Tehillim. Morai v'rabotai, I've met Rabbi Tzvi Grumblat here this evening. Rabbi Grumblat, please stand up. Where are you? Rabbi Grumblat, I am the father of Yael Michaeli. Baruch Hashem, she's fine. She's living with her beautiful family in Zichron Yaakov. But I want to publicly thank you, Rabbi Grumblat, for the Mesirut Nefesh and the Maaseh Chesed which you displayed on that night so long ago. What you did is to me the very quintessence of what the Lubavitcher Shluchim do all the time. And this surely is a Rebbe's legacy. It is a legacy of boundless Mesirut Nefesh and Maaseh Chesed, infused with Torah Israel and Ahavat Israel, and it is with this synergy which has made Lubavitch the greatest movement for the spread of Yiddishkeit among Klal Israel anywhere and at any time. Day by day, you are handing out matches to ignite Jewish souls the world over. And this is what makes you, the Shluchim, absolutely unique in the Jewish world. And as for the rest of us, ours is a task, especially in these turbulent economic times, to guarantee that you, Shluchim, will never ever lack the means to carry out and expand your sacred mission. We simply cannot afford to allow Lubavitch to suffer because of turbulent stock markets. Indeed, the more Lubavitch thrives, the more are we all enriched, and the more do we all prosper. So I say to you, the Shluchim, Aluva. יצליחו, חזקו ואימצו, שירבו כמוכם בישראל.